Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Good to be in worship with you here today, and thank you for coming to worship on this Veterans Day Sunday. A unique opportunity for us to give thanks to those men and women who have sacrificed so much, both living and those residing in the heavenly realm for our country. Today is Veterans Day Sunday, and I would invite you, if you haven't already done so, to sign in on the Friendship Pew Pad, which you'll find a little red book there. And a reminder to you today that we have a few scant weeks before Christmas, or so it seems. And you know how things go. I would say simply this: if you would like to sing with the Christmas, delighted to have you join us. We actually begin our Christmas music repertoire this Wednesday at 5:30, and Greg would be delighted to take you in under his wings, as will we in the coming weeks.
5 o'clock.
Thank you. My bad. Today we celebrate the Lord's Supper as well, and just a reminder that the Lord's table here at First Congregational Church is open to all people, including our youth, should you as parents decide to allow them to partake. We would ask that you partake of the bread when you are ready, signifying our individual communion with God, and that you would hold the cup of grape juice so that we may partake together, symbolizing our unity in Jesus Christ. So at this time, I would like to invite all who are able to please rise. Let's take a moment to greet those around us, especially our guests this morning. Please remain standing as we continue in worship today. I would invite you now to bow with me for a word of prayer as we prepare for worship. Oh dear God, we come to you on this Veterans Day Sunday to remember those who have given their youth and their strength and their very lives. Our honored veterans, both living and now residing in your heavenly realm. We thank you, Lord, for their loyalty to our nation, their ongoing contributions to her values, and that they each have found you to be a very present help in times of trouble. We are grateful for their dedication and commitment and the countless selfless acts that they have performed, the sacrifices their families have made and loved ones, so that we might continue to enjoy our freedom. We are mindful of the fact that many of their comrades sacrificed their very lives on the fields, on the seas, and in the air, where the battles of the war were fought. And so it is that we also remember those today with great reverence and thanksgiving. Continue your blessings upon us as we worship you today. In the name of your Son and our Savior, Jesus Christ, who gave his life that we would have the gift of new life. Amen.
Amen. I'm not doing the responsive and call to worship. Please join me now in the responsive call to worship. God is ready to answer us even before we call. God is eager to listen even when we are not yet ready to speak. Come quickly to my rescue. Be my rock and my refuge and a strong fortress to save me. The Lord is close to God saves those who are crushed in spirit. We wait and hope for the Lord. God is our help and our shield. In him our hearts rejoice, for we trust in his holy name. O God, let us place our hope and trust always in you. May your unfailing love rest upon us, our country, and our world. Amen. Our opening hymn is O Zion, haste thy mission high fulfilling.
Our first reading this morning comes to us from the Old Testament book of the Psalms. Hear now the words from Psalm 98. O sing to the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. His right hand and his holy arm have gotten him victory. The Lord has made known his victory. He has revealed his vindication in the sight of the nations. He has remembered his steadfast love and faithfulness to the house of Israel. All the ends of the earth have seen the victory of our God. Make a joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Break forth into joyous song and sing praises. Sing praises to the Lord with the lyre and the sound of the melody, with trumpets and the sound of the horn. Make a joyful noise before the King, the Lord. Let the sea roar and all that fills it, the world and those who live in it. Let the floods clap their hands. Let the hills sing together for joy at the presence of the Lord, for he is coming to the earth to judge. He will judge the world with righteousness and the peoples with equity. All who are able, please rise.
Glory be.
be seated. I'll give you just a little heads up this morning during the choir anthem today. You all will have a piece of the action. During the reprise in the middle, we're going to sing one verse of My Country, 'Tis of Thee, and it will appear in the nick of time on the screen for you.
And I will turn around and conduct you when to begin, but then I'll turn around and keep conducting the choir. But keep singing when I turn back around, please. Okay.
Today, during our time of prayer, veterans, both living and those residing in God's heavenly glory, but before we acknowledge those who have experienced just this week loss and grief as friends and members of our church. On the anniversary of Todd Pushing's unexpected death, we remember Barb Brown, his grieving widow, and their beautiful family. We also lift up today in this beautiful bouquet by the pulpit as a reminder of the death of Kurt Strand, Romain Strand's loved son, and for their family, so close following the funeral just yesterday. We pray for God's healing love that surrounds us and them even now. And we remember new member, Adara of Estuckenbrook, who lost her mother this week, Karen. And we remember yet another new member, Joy Rolson, and her uncle Arthur, who sustained a brain injury this week. We have been asked to pray for his recovery. And now we turn our attention to the veterans. The slideshow you're about to see is intended to be a time of silence for us to ponder the gifts of their lives and their dedication. And as you view the slideshow, you'll note that above some of the flags there will be a gold star, and that's a reminder to us of those who have passed on into God's glory and reside in the heavenly realm. But for family and friends connected to these loved veterans, let us focus our silent prayer today on them. Thank you. Will you bow with me in prayer? We've shared together, O God, in the wonderful joys of life, untold blessings, untold gifts we have received as your loved children, as citizens in this great nation, O God. We sometimes forget that those gifts come at a cost. And so we lift up in our hearts and minds the names and the faces of loved ones who have served in the United States military in all five branches of the service, men and women. And our hearts are humbled by the gifts of their sacrifice and their courage. We thank you for the blessings that we have received as citizens in this grand country. And we ask, O God, that we would continue to be courageous in our own right, to fight unrighteousness when we see it, to speak out when others are treated unjustly, to courageously and hopefully move forward in faith, no matter whatever obstacles or challenges lay in our path. And in so doing, we will be living out a legacy of love and life and courage and hope and new life. And it does not escape our attention today that your Son and our Savior Jesus Christ also fought for such things. His values and our values, may they be one. We thank you for his love so great that he saw past all of the divisions that exist in the human family. So great was his forgiveness that he could turn and offer forgiveness to those who had wronged him. So great his hope and love that he placed his own life in your care and trust, even on the cross, so that he would realize the day of resurrection. There's the new life we need, O God. There's the bright, shining example of what our daily strife and struggle as your people is about. Your heavenly rewards here and in the world to be. Strengthen us, O God, as only you can through your Holy Spirit. May we be found faithful and courageous and vigilant in our faith. And now hear us, O God, as we gather all of our voices into one, proclaiming the truth of who and whose we are as your loved children, saying together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
This morning's reading comes to us from Luke, 21st chapter, verses 5 through 19. It's found on page 85 in your pew Bible. When some were speaking about the temple, how it was adorned with beautiful stones and gifts dedicated to God, Jesus said, As for these things that you see, the day will come when not one stone will be left upon the other. All will be thrown down. They asked him, Teacher, when will this be? And what will be the sign that this is about to take place? And he said, Beware that you are not led astray. For many will come in my name and say, I am he. and that the time is near. Do not go after them. When you hear of wars and insurrections, do not be terrified, for these things must first take place. But the end will not follow immediately. Then he said to them, "Nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. There will be great earthquakes, and in various places, famines and plagues. And there will be dreadful portents and great signs from heaven. But before all of this occurs, they will arrest you and persecute you. They will hand you over to synagogues and prisons. And you will be brought before kings and governors because of my name. This will give you an opportunity to testify. So make up your minds not to prepare your defense in advance, for I will give you words and a wisdom that none of your opponents will be able to withstand or contradict. You will be betrayed even by parents and brothers, by relatives and friends, and they will put some of you to death. You will be hated by all because of my name. But not a hair of your head will perish. By your endurance, you will gain your souls." May God add meaning and blessing and an understanding of his word this day. I'd like to begin first by saying that it's an honor to be counted as a veteran of the United States, and an honor to have served this wonderful country, to stand among the other veterans that were shown on the screen this morning was truly humbling. To the unsung heroes that were recognized today, thank you for your service. And thank you for your continued service, not only to our country, but to our communities, our church, and to each other. Meet their tribulations alone. Where we are, Christ is also. And for our country, where we are, our veterans are there also. In a fleeting moment, in times of peril, and during times of endless solitude, we thank you all. And speaking of fleeting moments, I thought long and hard about today's meditation. When you hear of wars and uprisings, do not be frightened. I went a little different direction this morning. I think we've had enough of fear and tribulation thrown at us on the news and on Facebook and social media, so we're going to go a different direction. I would like to speak this morning a little bit about ice sculptures and sidewalk art and sand sculptures. You know what I mean? Artists spend hours and upon hours creating wonderful, beautiful works of art, carving shapes out of a block of ice, applying pastels on concrete, laying out a design, placing grains of sand just so, and then in a moment, when the temperatures rise or the rains come down, the art is destroyed. It's gone. It's just gone. And I don't understand it. I, for one, couldn't do it. I couldn't take all that time and spend all of that energy and put so much of my imagination, my skill, myself into a work of art only to see it destroyed, so quickly gone, as if it never was. If I'm going to make an effort to create something beautiful, I want it to last. And you know, I like music. I'm not a choir. I hope that some of you do as well. I love to make a joyful noise. And it's no different. You play the piece, you sing the song, you create something beautiful out of your imagination, your skill, out of yourself, and then it's gone. The music is not the notes on the page, The music only comes to life. The music is when it is performed. And when the performance is done, the music is gone. It remains only a memory. Music is art created in time, art created for a moment. Its beauty is temporary and fleeting. Music, like ice sculpture or sidewalk art or sand sculptures, is what is called perishable art. And so is cooking. And so is dance. So is gymnastics, or any sport for that matter, because sport too is about applying skill and imagination, your body, yourself, to create something beautiful for a moment. A leaping catch, a soaring dunk, a beautiful sequences of passes that results in a goal, beautiful sequence of jumps and spin on ice. You do it, and then it's gone. It doesn't last forever. And the same is true with preaching. What I do on a few Sundays, what Scott does, is perishable art. So what are we doing together? What are we building? What are we building here together? Perishable art. All this you see, Jesus said, when not a single stone here will be left in place. All this you see, this beauty here, these stained glass windows, this vaulted ceiling, the beautiful organ. A time will come when none of it will remain, when all of it will be gone. So what are we building? Perishable art. Do I find this concept upsetting, or do I see it as liberating? I think I do actually appreciate perishable art, and I think that you all do as well, because your enthusiastic and generous response to the 2017 stewardship appeal proves it. There was no appeal for a capital project. You weren't being asked to renovate the sanctuary, put on a new roof, fix the organ, do a kitchen makeover, things that you can touch and say, that's what my money did. No, instead, you invested in a mission, in music, in ministry, in the day-to-day operations of being church together. You were asked to invest in perishable art, and you did. And that's what we're doing. We're building perishable art. That's what we do as the members of the United Church of Christ. And that's what we are. For a while, for a few moments, for a few years, for a short span of time between birth and death, we use imagination and skill, our very selves, to make something beautiful out of our lives that we have been there, and it's beautiful. And then it is over, then it is gone. We ourselves are perishable art. So when I think about that, I think, if I am perishable art, what does that mean for the way that I want to live my life, the way you want to live your life? I thought about Francis of Assisi, a person that we've studied in class. As a young man, he rode his horse out of Assisi into battle, into a horrific endeavor that was the Crusades, joining those who sought to make their mark, their lasting mark, on the shape of the world. And he came back, not a knight, but a fool. No more trying to change the world. Instead, the world entirely changed him. Seeing the world and everything in it from a wholly new perspective, as if he were standing on his head, because God had turned him upside down. And for us, for that matter, our political system has seemed to turn us all upside down. Francis called himself and the band of followers who joined him La Jongleurs de Dieu. For those that speak French, pardon me. God's jugglers, God's jesters, God's fools. In his biography of Francis, G.K. Chesterton writes, "Francis really meant what he said when he had found the secret of life is in being a servant. There was to be found in such service a freedom almost amounting to frivolity. It was comparable to the condition of the juggler because it almost amounted to frivolity. The gesture could be free where the night was rigid. Because the night bears the heavy burden of duty, the heavy weight of trying to fulfill a daunting mission, of trying to complete an elusive quest, while the jester plays and juggles and laughs. Why can the jester do all these things? Because he is free, he and she. Because the fate of the world does not depend on them. Les jugglers de Dieu, God's fools. Know that the fate of the world does not depend on us. We are the fools, we are jesters, we are jugglers, we are servants, not holding the fate of the world in our hands, but playing, creating, making fun, making beauty, all to bring delight to the master. We are art, perishable art, and that is liberating. We are free, free to be what we are, free to be God's delight. We tread this world lightly, not with the heavy steps of determination and ambition and moral indignation, but with light and airy steps of a dancer. Not to say that determination and ambition are wrong. It's just God wants us to take delight in life. God is maker of heaven and earth, not us. God is the beginning and the end, not us. Artists, here for a brief moment, doing what we can, using skill and imagination that we have been given to make something beautiful. What do we have to lose? Nothing, because it is not ours to lose. And what do we have to gain? Well, everything, because every moment of being gives us a new opportunity to bring God delight. And bringing God delight is delight. We've been following Luke this fall, and we've been talking about some of the distinctive marks of being a follower of Jesus. Some of the things that mark us, some of the things that people see in us when we follow Jesus. We now have quite a list, so I'd like to cover some of those. When we follow Jesus, we want to do one thing. We don't want many things, we just want one thing. We want Jesus. We want to be where he is, go where he goes. When we follow Jesus, our hearts are wide open, we are welcoming, loving, including anybody and everybody. When we follow Jesus, we are generous. We don't hold on to stuff. We use stuff to bring blessings to other people, especially to people who have little. When we follow Jesus, we live by faith. We may not even have much faith at all, as we discussed with the mustard seed. But we use whatever faith we have, no matter how small, because Jesus says whatever faith we have is enough. When we follow Jesus, we are grateful. We are grateful not just for the gift, but for the giver. When we follow Jesus, we never give up. We never give up. When we follow Jesus, we are humble. We know that everything is a gift. We know that on our own, we are lost. And that life, new life, comes only by God's grace. We do not rely on our own wisdom, but we let God be God and us be us, the humble creatures, the dependent children that we are. So make up your minds, Jesus said, and not prepare your defense in advance, for I will give you words and a wisdom that none of your opponents will be able to withstand or contradict. Living our life based on the wisdom and on our faith in the Lord, this will give us the words and actions that we need. When we follow Jesus, we don't put too much stake in any building, in any institution, in any political party, or any cause. When we follow Jesus, we're not crusaders or builders of any monument. When we follow Jesus, we are dancers. We are jugglers. We are jesters. When we follow Jesus, we are artists, and we are the art, shining brightly for a brief moment, making something beautiful out of the lives we've been given in honor and in praise and the utter delight of our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
We'll now celebrate the Lord's Supper. God in Christ breaks down the walls that make us strangers to ourselves and divides us one from another. We are the body of Christ. Around this table, we enact our faith. The body broken is restored to wholeness. The lifeblood poured out brings healing to our world.
Gathered together, we remember that on the evening when Christ was betrayed, he took bread and having blessed it, he broke it, saying, "This is my body broken for each of you for the forgiveness of sin."
In the same way, after supper, he took the cup, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this, and as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Come, the invitation has been made. The table is ready.
Thank you.
The blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, shed in love for you, take and drink.
Lord, for the healing that you have given us in the brokenness of the bread and the pouring of the cup, we thank you. For the community that you have restored in us through the sharing of life, we thank you. For the courage and strength that you have promised to us, even as we have honored the ones of courage in our own lives, we thank you. Send us forth from this place in love, letting justice be worked out with gentleness and power known in the presence of your Spirit. Amen.
Amen. We have the opportunity to courageously give through the offering of ourselves and our possessions to the work God calls us to. We cannot begin to repay God for the multitude of blessings, our privileges and the abundance of resources that we enjoy daily. But we can respond to God's infinite goodness with acts of gratitude and kindness and generosity and love towards others. Let us give generously as God has given so generously to us. Will the ushers please come forward? Thank you. Please join with me in our unison prayer of dedication on the screen. We rejoice, O God, in the new world order you are creating around and within us. We give thanks for the joy we find in the church as we draw water from the wells of your salvation. It is our intention to share the joy, to proclaim your word among all people, and to work quietly and enthusiastically for a world where your light of your love once and for all overcomes the darkness of prejudice and hatred and division everywhere. To these ends, we dedicate our offerings. Amen.
Fellowship following the service. It has been a joy and honor to be in worship with you this day. Thank you, Margaret, for the beautiful music this morning, and thank you, Greg, and the amazing choir for your gift this morning, and thank you, Pastor Scott, for the beautiful veterans tribute that you did and for doing the reading this morning. May you all feel the presence of the Holy Spirit guiding you in the week ahead. Please join now in our responsive benediction. Take with you today the assurance of healing and wholeness. May God's steadfast love and faithfulness accompany both us and our country.
We praise God, for we know that our future is in God's capable hands.
We will sing praises for the victories God makes possible through us.
O God, we place our hope and trust always in you. May your steadfast love endure forever.
Amen.
Your blood.